Sometimes you get this type of error. It is known as blue screen error. It is known as restart error. It is also known as inaccessible boot device. Well, whatever it is and what are the reasons behind, leave that. Let's simply fix it with easy and quick method. When you start your system, it restarts and this error occurs. It again restarts and again this error occurs. But finally, it goes for preparing automatic repair and then diagnosing your PC. Ultimately, you get this type of window with two options, restart and advanced options. You need to click on advanced options. Then these three options will be opened. Now you just need to click on troubleshoot. And then these four options will be opened. You have to click on advanced options. Now here are again so many options. You just need to open command prompt. Now here will be so many users that are in your system. Just like there is only administrator account in my system. So you need to log in with any of your user account. But it is recommended that you should open with administrator. So click on administrator, put your password, enter your password and simply hit enter or click on continue. Now this type of command window will be opened. This is known as command prompt. Now right here C colon, just like this, C colon, and press enter. So now here you will be gone. Now write CD Windows and system 32. Write this line here. When you wrote this line, after that write this line. Now again hit enter. You will go here. Now again write CD config. Now you will be in config. Basically we are entering into configure folder. This is the folder and we have come here by this method. Actually this is the folder where we have to go. Now write dir. Dir directory means you will see the content in configure folder. Hit enter. These are the folders available in config folder. Now you can see regbag. It stands for registry bag. Basically now we will go to the default registry. Means there are 5 folders that we have to get them back to the default position. Now how? Simply open registry regbag. Right? Now write here CD regbag and enter. Now you have entered into regbag folder. Now you can see the content of its folder by writing dir. Hit enter. Now as you can see there are the five folders: system, software, security, same and default. Actually these are the default folders. We have to copy these folders to configure folder. As you can see here, default, there is the data, same, there is the data, security, there is the data, software, there is the data, system, there is the data. So actually we have to remove these folders and copy these folders to here. This default, same, security, software and system. How we will do this? First we will rename these folders from configuration folder and then we will copy folders, these 5, from regbag from here to configure folder here. There's nothing a big logic, I think. Simply these 5 folders we have to rename and we have to copy these folders to here. Now we will go back to configure folder to rename these folders. Simply CD, write CD dot dot, hit enter. You have entered into config folder. Now simply rename default to default 1, REN, neo for default, default 1. Enter, rename same to same 1. Enter, rename security to security 1. Enter, rename software to software 1. Enter, rename system to system 1. Enter. Now again, come back to register folder. Now as we have successfully renamed these folders, now come back to registry back folder and copy these folders to here. So simply write cd regback, enter. Now you have entered into regback. Now write here copy asterisk c colon slash windows slash system 32 and config. Just hit enter. Now these folders are simply copied to config folder. Now to confirm, you can write cd dot dot, hit enter. You have come in configure folder, write dir, hit enter. Now as you can see, default is 0, SAM is 0, security is 0, software is 0, system is 0. So we have successfully copied these 5 folders from registry back to configure. Now simply exit, write exit, hit enter. Now you will see these 3 options. Simply click on turn off your PC and it will restart, and then successfully you will see your system solved, fixed with this problem. Thank you, and yes, don't forget to subscribe.